Hey everyone, I'm Willie, your Merced real estate agent. In this video, I'll try to give you guys some comfort by explaining why the housing market in Merced will not be hit as hard in a crash this year, if there's even going to be one. There's been a lot of national media reporting of an upcoming housing bubble in the US, and there are lots of people saying that you should prepare yourself for a crash and save your money to buy into the dip when it does crash. Even if there is a crash, there's lots of factors that will help mitigate some of its effects in Merced. One of the factors that people first think about is the fact that Merced is still a college town, with both UC Merced and Merced College having a total enrollment of around 20,000 students who still need to go to school and they also need a place to live. While this is a big part of the story, the local real estate market need a little more in-depth analysis. So let me tell you what the situation is like here. Following a typical seasonal home buying cycle this year, demand is starting to level off from the height of late spring and early summer this year. And while it's still a very strong seller's market, buyers may find that it's just slightly easier to find a home nowadays. As a local agent with some firsthand knowledge, here are 3 points I've witnessed in the past few weeks and months. Number one, I'm seeing home builders slow down their releases, not due to any sort of downturn, but it's mostly because of a lack of construction materials and especially construction workers due to the pandemic. Labor is being spread so thin that other construction projects in the entire region are seeing long delays. These home builders are seeing so many delays because they sold too many homes earlier this year because they didn't necessarily anticipate these circumstances in the middle of 2021. I've seen homes go from a normal 6 month completion time to now more than 8+ months. And as a result of this, home releases slow to a trickle of just a small handful of homes every month per builder. And with about 5 active developments in Merced, this means only a couple dozen new homes are built each month. This is definitely not enough to keep up with demand. Number two, the second point is that there's a very low inventory of affordable homes, as defined by the FHA loan limit of $356,000 in Merced. It's very rare for me to see anything under this amount now, whether it's new or resale homes. On the low end, I'm seeing $370,000, but many homes are now above $400,000. While considered low in California standards, this still represents a significant increase from 2 or 3 years ago. This increase in prices is driving away local home buyers from this area and forcing them to continue renting. I see that this drives up demand for the overall rental market, which in turn is creating good buying opportunities for investors. The third point is that we are experiencing a severe student housing crisis, and UC Merced is forced to delay the start of instruction as a result. Even Merced Station, an apartment complex geared towards UC Merced students, that was supposed to be completed by now is facing major delays of over a month, and more than 1,100 students are left to find other options. This is in part caused by the fact that UC Merced had record enrollment with 2,000 more students attending the university in 2021 compared to 4 years ago. Although Merced has grown a lot as a city, the housing supply has not kept up with this influx of students on top of other families looking to call Merced their home. The vast majority of new homes built are not bought or rented by students, so the housing shortage will continue until the city builds significantly more housing units or the university builds thousands of more dorm rooms. In the meantime, I predict that real estate investors will come here and continue to prop up home prices because they know that student home rentals will continue to provide a good return on their investments. To sum up the situation in Merced, I think it's important to look at the local level market as opposed to the macro level news headlines that cover the US market as a whole. The fear of a housing crash in Austin, Texas, for example, doesn't necessarily mean we will see a housing crash in Merced. These markets are just very different. If you're an investor, just know that there's always risk in any investment. To be an informed buyer, I would recommend using the following data to help you see what is really happening here. One key metric I like to use is to compare the growth rate of home prices versus the growth rate of rental prices to quickly assess investment risk. In a safe market, we want to see as close to a 1-to-1 ratio or lower, but not negative, of both growth rates, like a 10% growth in home prices should also be accompanied by a 10% growth of rental prices. For Merced, home prices have gone up 16% since the last year, and rental prices have gone up 13% in the same time period. Compare that to another market like Austin, Texas, where home prices are up 38%, but rental prices fail to match that with an increase of only 13%. Comparing these ratios, we see that Austin has almost triple the investment risk compared to Merced. The next things to watch out for as an investor are the inventory on the market, how long it's taking to sell, whether homes are getting sold above or below list price, and these are all things I will cover in my next video, the Merced Housing Market Update. So stay tuned and subscribe so you don't miss out. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next one.